One of the exciting places I am taking you on our travels is to Little Rock, Arkansas, and to Central High School. Central High School is one of the first schools to desegregate in the American South. It's one of the biggest high schools I've ever seen. Students go to school on the first floor, second floor, third floor, fourth floor, there's even a fifth floor. 1957, these 9 black students volunteered to go to high school there. Here's your speaker, Minnie Jean Brown Trickey. Minnie Jean was the most terrorized of the 9. Now, why do I say terrorized? Minnie Jean is 5'10". People degraded her because of her height. They degraded her because she was a woman. They degraded her because she was an African American. Minnie Jean fought back, nonviolently, of course. Look at these photos, please. I know she's smiling, but I don't call those photos a smile of joy. I call them a smile of blank. Plug in the blank. What word would you use? Smile of hope? Wonderful. Smile of courage? Lovely. I call these photos a smile of defiance. Minnie Jean was not going to let them be her. Minnie Jean was the only one of the 9 who was expelled. She's expelled in February 1958. She's suspended in December. Let me share with you why. December 1957, Minnie Jean is in the cafeteria. She has a bowl of chili. She has a roll. She has a milk. She's walking down. Students stick out their chairs, call her the N-word. She walks by, another student sticks out his chair, another student, another student. Minnie Jean doesn't say anything, but it's obviously so hurtful. She takes her tray and she drops it. Chili spills on 2 or 3 boys. The students who were terrorizing her were not suspended. They suspended Minnie Jean for what they called the chili incident, dropping chili on white kids. You are going to have a child who's in high school or college whose teacher is going to say Minnie Jean took the chili and she dumped it over someone's head, because that's how it's taught in documentaries and in books. Well, if a teacher ever says that and your child is sitting in their classroom, I want your child to do this. Teacher says, Minnie Jean dumped the chili, jump out of your seat, run to the front of the class and say, stop the lesson! That is a bold-faced lie. You'll be suspended, of course. But isn't there always a price we pay for truth in this country? Why am I taking time to go over chili? Because history has shamed Minnie Jean. She has been shamed by this. What does Minnie Jean say she did? Her words. She says, she accidentally dropped her tray. On purpose. I don't know what it means, but I really... Why was Minnie Jean expelled? She's in the hallway, February 1958. And girls come up to her, and they take locks that you put on a locker in a small pocketbook, and they throw it at Minnie Jean. Hits her in the head. Minnie Jean calls the students white trash. The students who hit her were not expelled. They expelled Minnie Jean for these 4 words. Verbal retaliation after provocation. I also say they expelled her for these 5 words at the bottom of the screen. Inappropriate language after being attacked. This is the beautiful Minnie Jean in 1957. This is the beautiful Minnie Jean today. Now, Minnie Jean never knew why she was the one who was attacked, why she was the one most terrorized. A woman wrote a book a number of years ago called Bitters in the Honey. In it, she interviewed only white women who had gone to school with the 9. Only white women to find out what they thought. Minnie Jean read this book, she cried for days because she didn't know why she was the target. One woman said it. The reason we hate Minnie Jean so much is because she walked the halls like she belonged there. How many of us out there walk halls like we belong there, and we do, and someone's ever made us feel like we don't belong? Minnie Jean has paid the price. Take a look at these photos. This is Minnie Jean with our students. Minnie Jean hugging 2 of our students. Why is she doing this? Because she is on our trip for the full trip. How exciting is that? One of the Little Rock 9 is traveling with us. That doesn't happen for people anywhere else in the country. You are able to meet Minnie Jean. She does an anti-racism presentation. She leads us in a session on music and the civil rights movement. Having Minnie Jean with us is a blessing. I affectionately call her the Queen of Sojourn. Let's jump to 1957. It's the 40th anniversary of the students desegregating Central High School. Cameras are in Little Rock interviewing people in Little Rock, Arkansas, how they feel about the celebration. Then you're going to see all nine walk in. As all nine walk into a press conference, Minnie Jean is going to be asked, "Were you expelled because of chili?" Listen to her answer.
Yes, I know a little about the anniversary. I've heard a little talk.
I'm vaguely aware of the anniversary of the high school.
I don't know anything about the anniversary, sir. No, I don't know about the Little Rock Nine.
One of the greatest stories of the Civil Rights Movement is the story of you and the bowl of chili in the cafeteria. One thing I'm curious about is I've read it a couple of different ways in terms of whether that specific incident was responsible for your expulsion or whether it was something else.
Well, I think the reason for my expulsion was that I was tall, beautiful, and proud. And I've had a lot of time to think about that. And I'm not going to go through the story of the chili, because the chili incident is symbolic of what happens when one is tall, beautiful, and proud, and unlike the stereotype of what a young black woman should be. I've tried to explain that to my kids, that I wasn't a violent person. I was steeped in nonviolence, but I did have emotions.
Tall, beautiful, and proud. Think about that. Tall, beautiful, and proud. Let's take the words beautiful and proud. Women in high school and college are called oftentimes B-I-T-C-H amongst other words. So we argue degrading words, misogynistic words need to leave our vocabulary, and beautiful and proud comes in. Every woman has a right to feel beautiful and proud. Every woman has a right to feel beautiful and proud. And who exemplifies that better than Minnie Jean Brown Trickey? I'm not sure anybody does. Again, our students with Minnie Jean, you can see a variety of young people with her. Minnie Jean's favorite quote is from the great Indian leader Gandhi. "We have to be the change we want to see in the world." We're tired of people talking the talk. Not only do you meet Minnie Jean Brown Trickey, I'm also going to take you to Central High School. You see how beautiful it is. We do a lesson right in the courtyard, where those nine were terrorized. This is a picture of the 101st Airborne. It was the National Guard that kept the nine out of school. President Eisenhower called in the U.S. Army to get them in. Here's a picture of the nine walking up the stairs on their first day of school when they're allowed into this high school. You see them walking up. What are you going to do? You're walking in those exact same steps. You're walking in historical footprints. How did the nine put up with this? How did they do it? This trip is all framed around nonviolence. Nonviolence believes the universe is on the side of justice. The nonviolent resistor has deep faith that justice will eventually win. So not only are you meeting Minnie Jean Brown Trickey, you're going to go to statues of the nine on the Arkansas Capitol grounds, so you'll be able to touch Minnie Jean's statue. You're going to go to the high school, and you are going to see the Little Rock Visitor Center, which is an amazing, amazing museum. It is a fabulous day in Arkansas, led by Minnie Jean Brown Trickey.